In this part in my A Song of Isildvara Witches series, we will be focusing on Tyanna of the Tower and Visenya Targaryen. One of the three queens that would eventually come to rule King Maegor Targaryen was the Pentoshi witch Tyanna. She was called the Mistress of Whispers. Tyanna had pale skin and dark black hair, and it was said that she could speak to spiders and rats who would come to her in the night and tell her of those who spoke negatively against Maegor. It was said that no secret could be kept from her within the Red Keep. Tyanna is also associated with ravens. Tyanna in some ways seems to be reminiscent of some incarnations of Morgan le Fay from Arthurian myth, specifically Morgaine from The Mist of Avalon by Marion Zimmer Bradley. Tyanna was thought to be the base-born daughter of a Pentoshi magister who rose from poverty as a courtesan. His grace might rule the Seven Kingdoms, men whispered, but he himself was ruled by three queens, his mother, Queen Visenya, his paramour, Queen Alice, and the Pentoshi witch, Queen Tyanna, the Mistress of Whispers. Tyanna had saved Maegor after he was wounded in a conflict with the warrior's sons. He was on the verge of death for 27 days before the witch Tyanna healed him with her strange magic. Queen Alice had brought Tyanna over from Pentos, and when the Dowager Queen Visenya met with her, she made Tyanna exclusively responsible for King Maegor's well-being. Many in Maegor's court did not approve of this. Nonetheless, Maegor was healed, and when he rose, he mounted the great beast Balerion the Black Dread and flew to Visenya's hill, where hundreds of warrior sons prayed. Maegor set the sept aflame, and the screams of burning men were heard throughout the city. In that same year, Tyanna of Pentos became Queen Tyanna. Later, in 44 AC, when Alyssa Valerion, Maegor's nephew Aenys' widow, stole Dark Sister and fled Dragonstone, her son, Prince Viserys, was given over to Tyanna. "Chain him in the black cell and question him sharply," Maegor commanded. "Ask him where his mother has gone." The prince, who had up until this point served as King Maegor's squire, was brutally tortured at the hands of the Pentoshi witch, lingering 9 long days until he finally succumbed to his injuries. In the end, Tyanna's sorcery proved no use. The prince had not known the whereabouts of his mother. Maegor left the 15-year-old prince's body to rot in the castle's ward for 2 weeks. Tyanna was never able to give children to Maegor, and when Maegor's other wife, Queen Alice, produces a monstrous stillborn child, Tyanna tells Maegor that he had been deceived. The witch tells him that the child was not his, that Queen Alice had betrayed him. He told Tyanna she was a jealous witch and barren, throwing the Grand Maester's head at her. "Spiders do not lie," the Mistress of Whispers replied. She handed the king a list. Tyanna convinced the king of Alice's infidelity, giving him a list of names. This would eventually lead to the extinction of all of House Harroway. Dragged from her bed, Queen Alice saw her sisters killed before her eyes as they tried to protect her. Her father, inspecting the Tower of the Hand, was flung from its roof to smash upon the stones below. Harroway's sons, brothers, and nephews were taken as well, thrown onto spikes that lined the dry moat around Maegor's holdfast. Some took hours to die. The simple-minded Horace Harroway lingered for days. The 20 names on Queen Tyanna's list soon joined them, and then another dozen men named by the first 20. Queen Alice's own long death at the hands of the witch Tyanna was so unspeakable that record of it was wiped from history. We only know that Maegor witnessed every moment, and when she finally was dead, her body was split into 7 parts and left to rot on spikes. Eventually, though, even Tyanna could not escape Maegor's fury. In 48 AC, when she was seized, she admitted to being responsible for the 2 stillborn creatures that had been born to Maegor. She said that she had poisoned them in the womb, and that Maegor's current pregnant wife would bear him the same. Though Maegor had silenced her forever with his sword, her words were true. Maegor's third child was monstrous as the first 2 were. Tyanna was seemingly a very evil sorceress. The text implies that she manipulated Maegor into destroying the Harroways out of jealousy for Queen Alice. Fire and Blood portrays Tyanna as taking great pleasure in the suffering of others. Throughout her time in Westeros, it would appear that she nurtures and encourages Maegor's ruthlessness, which leads to the brutal death of countless individuals. She no doubt also used sorcery in some cases to accomplish certain goals. All that being said, however, I do not think that Tyanna was responsible for Maegor's children, even though she admitted to it. I believe the person responsible for that was none other than Visenya Targaryen. Visenya died in 44 AC, before Maegor ever even had any children. So you might ask yourself, how could she be responsible? Well, Visenya Targaryen was also implied to be a witch. Yet there was darkness in Visenya Targaryen. To most of the world, she presented the grim face of a warrior, stern and unforgiving. Even her beauty had an edge to it, her admirer said. The oldest of the three heads of the dragon, Visenya was to outlive both of her siblings, and it was rumored that in her later years, when she could no longer wield a sword, she delved into the dark arts, mixing poisons and casting malign spells. Some even suggest that she might have been a kinslayer and a kingslayer, though no proof has ever been offered to support such calumnies. I believe that Visenya's interest in the arcane began long before she was no longer able to wield a sword. Visenya is also described throughout the book Fire and Blood as becoming more and more witch and crone-like as time went on. When King Aegon I and his sister wives all lived, Aegon clearly loved Rhaenys more as a lover, but Visenya was the stronger sister. I would argue that Visenya was more key to Aegon's success than Rhaenys, though I do not deny that Rhaenys was also key. Rhaenys was the first of the sisters to give birth. She had Aenys in 7 AC. Visenya, however, even after 5 years, had still not become pregnant. And with Rhaenys now dead, and Visenya seemingly barren, many were suggesting that King Aegon marry another woman. But suddenly, amongst all this talk, Visenya announced that she was in fact pregnant, and somehow she knew beyond a shadow of a doubt that it would be a boy. Is it possible that there was something unnatural about Maegor's conception? Is it possible that dark magic is what led to the birth of one of the evilest rulers in the history of Westeros? Maegor was cruel from his childhood, though he was vital and strong, especially compared to his brother. He would be possessing of all the traits of a good king if not for the darkness in him. Could Maegor's unnatural origins also be the reason that his children came out the way they did? A key theme of A Song of Ice and Fire is balance. Magic has rules and a heavy price. Maegor was never meant to be king. It was never his right. If Visenya did do sorcery to produce a king, it is highly ironic that this king would be able to produce no heirs. It balances the scale. It is known that Visenya and Tyanna spoke secretly when the Pentoshi woman arrived from across the narrow sea. What could they have spoken of, and why did Visenya trust this woman to take full care of Maegor, banishing the other servants? I think secrets were exchanged here. Deals were made. Tyanna had known that Maegor's other wife would produce a stillborn heir, but not because she had poisoned her, but because Visenya had told her years earlier. I think that Visenya may have offered Tyanna queenship in exchange for saving Maegor. She would not oppose her. It seems a bit odd that Maegor would be taken to Tyanna so quickly otherwise. Maegor listened to his mother. She was the first of the three queens which ruled him. Her influence was great, and there may have also been sorcery involved. Interestingly enough, Visenya Targaryen withered and died not long after this, taking the secret of Maegor's strange conception with her, with the exception of Tyanna, if this theory is correct. Perhaps Visenya had even planned for Tyanna to do what she had done, calling on the Arcane to bear a son for Maegor. But as I said earlier, Tyanna never bore any children to Maegor. The question is, if she knew the secret, then why not? Well, perhaps Tyanna isn't as dark as she is portrayed in Fire and Blood. Maegor was an evil king, and there is no denying that. But Tyanna, being a mysterious foreign sorceress, was met with immediate suspicion and resentment from her very first moment in the Red Keep. Maegor himself eventually accused Tyanna of being the cause of his stillborn children, which she admitted to. This couldn't have possibly shown a good light on her historically. The bottom line is, we really don't have very much evidence that Tyanna was actually as evil as the book portrays her to be. We know that she was very likely skilled in many esoteric arts, which Maegor used to his advantage. Initially, Tyanna may have hoped to manipulate Maegor, but it seems that even she lost control. The unnatural darkness in him was perhaps too strong for even her to overcome. I think Tyanna did some terrible things, yes, but only because she was forced to use her skills for those purposes by Maegor. I put forth that Tyanna saw what Visenya had created in Maegor, and chose not to birth another like him into the world. I think Tyanna died with Visenya's secret. She would have been the only other person who knew of Maegor's unnatural origins. The last irony of all this is, Maegor was killed by the Iron Throne itself. A throne, I might add, that he was never meant to sit. Balance. Thank you guys for watching. If you like this channel, consider supporting it on Patreon. For more of my recent A Song of Ice and Fire theories, check out the recent A Song of Ice and Fire theories playlist on this channel,